Do you know that almost 80% of every 100 liters of water pumped for human consumption ends up as waste? Where is all this water going? Is it being treated properly? What are the challenges that the RWAs face with respect to STP water? What does KSPCB's new initiative in this regard say? We will explore and discuss all aspects on this subject in today's show. Hello, I'm Priyanka Rachaya. Welcome to Property Matters. Population boom and rampant urbanization has not just taken a toll on our natural resources, but it's also testing the capacities and is posing new challenges to the city infrastructure as well. And one such major challenge is that of treated water and its disposal.
The city, which is already built up some 40, 50 years back, there was no concept of high-rise. So our sewer system, UGD, pipeline diameter, the design, everything is made considering independent houses. At one point, suddenly, you know, so many flats and so much of sewage enters into the system, it can't take up. Roughly, we have in Bangalore, 1000 MLD, that is 100 crore liters of water, which is treated and to the good extent, and being wasted, so including the BWSSBs.
In order to tackle this issue, the Karnataka State Pollution Control Board has come up with a new initiative that's one of its kind in the entire nation.
We are trying to come out with a good initiative for the first time in India, wherein this treated sewage is going to be made mandatory for all the corporation parks and Bangalore Development Authority parks and forest lands. We are working out the logistics, how to transport this treated sewage to them. So they get enough water, instead of using fresh water, they are conserving.
And the government is all set to make usage of treated water compulsory for construction activities by April next year.
We are trying to, you know, make it mandatory to use the treated sewage, including in RMCs. A challenge is that we need to have a proper study to check whether it is safe. Prima facie, there are many, you know, papers submitted, but still, to ascertain, we have requested Indian Institute of Science based in Bangalore. There is a Center for Sustainable Development. We have requested them, and the study is going on, whether the treated sewage will have any effect on the corrosion of the steel and the strength of the building. So very shortly, we are hoping that from 1st of April, we want to insist all the construction projects to use only the treated sewage.
However, there's a lot of concern about this among the builders. They say construction is a one-time activity and that its quality must not be compromised at any cost, as it's a question of one's credibility. Who will ascertain the quality of water? And what if the quality of water is not consistent? These are some of the questions that they seek answers for.
Treated water has got its own drawback. If at all there are some issues with the performance, then it is going to be a problem on the long run. Treated water has got other usages, but I think we should not compromise on the construction process. Once if it is certified also, the overall quality of water, they will only give us the pH value, or they will only give the acidic value of it. And what will happen if the water is not consistent throughout? Quality must be consistent, no? I think it is not an advisable one. Otherwise, why is the need for having good quality sand, good quality concrete, everything? Okay. Water is a very important as a component of it.
However, in a response to the same, experts in the industry say that the builders have to take the responsibility of ascertaining the quality of water for construction, as the move is aimed at the larger good of the society and its future.
You want to buy the paint, you want to buy the flooring tile. How will you ensure the quality is right? Who looks at that? You do it. You and your team will have a quality control and quality assurance team. You will ensure that the right level of cement is used, right level of aggregate is used, right level of sand is used, right level of aggregate is used, and the right level of water is used. So you should have your own internal system to ensure that particular water has the right quality.
While these concerns are on one side, apartments generating excess treated water are facing another difficulty. They do not know what to do with the STP water that they are producing.
Many of the apartments have the STPs as a mandate and they are running it well. But the thing is that they cannot use the 100% of treated water. They can use only 40 to 50% to be reused for greenery, flush, and as well as car washing, floor washing, etc. Whereas nearly 50-60% of the water has to be left.
In November last year, the BWSSP had announced the development of a portal for selling of treated water. But there is no clear picture as to what its status currently is. Surely, there are a lot of issues that the government must resolve even before making it compulsory for usage of treated water at public parks and for construction purposes. And are these issues being taken into consideration? That's something that the government must answer. Do subscribe to MBTV and follow me on Twitter for more such videos concerning citizen issues. This is Priyanka Rachaya, signing off with camera person Pragat.
Please subscribe to Magic Bricks on YouTube and press the bell icon to get new videos.